콜라 주스 브랜 사우 믹스 부 내게 주고픈 칵테일을 브루 Red 귀 속이 쨍 고감에 상상 그 이상 기분 up and back Red But you wanna but you wanna dance like this 붙여보자 좋아 해요 솔직히 긴장이 담이 뚜뚜 귀엽지 사랑에 빠져 그려 우린 Red Red
Hey guys, this is Red Into Bullets. Welcome to my channel and the one and only first video of mine. As you could have found out by the title, today we will be discussing my K-pop opinions. Hope you'll enjoy, and without further ado, let's get into the video 1. Chungha is the best dancer of the third generation, while you're out there are arguing whether Momo, Seulgi or Lisa are better, I'm out here looking at you all wondering if you had ever heard of Chungha. No hate towards the other girls though, they still slay, and are talented as hell, but for me personally, Chungha is the best too. 2017 was the worst year for K-pop musically. Now, I have been a K-pop stan, since 2012 and 2017 was the worst. A lot of groups beloved by me were already disbanded or really inactive. A lot of survival shows were popular in which I was not interested in for me. Songs by K-pop groups during that year sounded very similar. The only K-pop group I've got into during that year was NCT. In my opinion, new boy groups all went for the dark EDM concept and all girls went for a cute one. I was listening to songs done only by groups which were already active for more than a rookie time 3. Mamamoo are better vocally than Red Velvet, okay, now. In the past, I used to be very biased Ravel love, and hated everybody that could be a competition to Red Velvet, thus I never accepted that Mamamoo are better than Red Velvet. But now that I do not care about competition anymore, I proudly agree that Mamamoo are better. Yes, Wendy probably is on their level too, and Seulgi perhaps, but the other girls of Red Velvet are much weaker vocalists than Mamamoo, so I think Mamamoo are better. Though I'm not a trained singer, it's just an observation from a listener 4. I don't really like Luna, since they debuted and had their solo projects, I never really cared for them. Their music is just not my style very much, even though I think they have very aesthetically pleasing music videos. I think that the thing that puts me off is the tone of their main vocalists. They have very soft voices of which I'm not the biggest fan of 5. I'm not a big fan of Stray Kids music, now before All Stays come at me with pitchforks. I actually really enjoy their songs and love the messages they are putting into them. I think their songs are bops and I'm jamming every time they are played in some video or anything. But I'm never coming out of my way to listen to them, somehow. I don't understand either, don't ask me. Love the boys, the 6. NCT deserves more fame in case of their music, uff, I can't stress enough how they are so underappreciated in case of their music. I love NCT's songs. But in comparison to funny videos of them, and love to the members, which is not at all bad, I see very little of the good words for their music. And I think that you can see it on the views too. The only songs that somehow every K-pop fan likes is Seventh Sense and Whiplash. Though, they are good, other songs exist too, you know 7. I don't mind Cory Booth and cultural appropriation in K-pop that much, now, don't get me wrong. I understand all the people that are hurt by cultural appropriation and I think they have every right to be hurt if their culture is used in a mocking or just fashionable way. But if it is used with good admiration, enough education and simply as love towards your culture, I think it is completely okay. However, my culture is never used in such a way, because who even would want to, though? I can't really speak for the people of the cultures that have been so many times misused, and I may have a big mouth. I apologize if that's the case. In the end, it's just the way I would feel, and each and every one of us has a right to feel the way they want to, and I think that you are entitled to be hurt either way. Now, for the Cory Booth. Yeah, they are weird, very much. All we do is laugh at them, but I guess if they want to embarrass themselves like that, let them. 8. The third generation of K-pop was my favorite. I mean, this is pretty self-explanatory. I already mentioned that I got into K-pop in 2012. I listen to many groups from the second generation as well, but the most well-known for me is third generation. Since I got into K-pop during that era, my significant K-pop sound is also in between 2010 and 2015 songs. In my opinion, second and first groups of third generation also had the most talent when it comes to singing, which I love very much. Those songs were the most vocal-based choruses that K-pop ever had, and I was here for it. I did not really like K-pop during 2017 and 2019. I even thought that I will stay and follow only my alts from now on. And then ATEEZ came and restored my faith in K-pop. LOL9. Throwing a member out of your group will not solve a scandal and sometimes even make it worse. The range of my anger was unmatched once I heard that IG kicked out B.I from Icon and Starship One Ho from Monster X. I mean, yeah, if the members stayed with the groups, the scandal would still be connected to the group and therefore would bring them down a little bit, but dude, it is still connected to the group because the members were well-known part of the group. It did not change anything, you satans. You only angered the fans, nothing more, nothing less. 10. I don't mind the repetition of formula in Blackpink's songs if the song will sound a little bit different instrumentally. Yeah, we all know the infamous formula that has been going on since 4DO. And even though it has the same way of production, the instrumentals are different, therefore the song sounds different if you are not paying too much attention to it. Or have different instruments used in it, so it will sound a bit different, even though the structure is the same. But you know what? Everyone was all fine and okay with enjoying Blackpink songs without these speculations, until some crazy haters did came out with such analysis. The power of these people is sometimes really inevitable. 11. I like Red Velvet's Velvet Side more, the most 50 over 50 opinion in the whole K-pop industry. Why? I don't know, it just fits better with me. Bad Boy, Peekaboo, Psycho, Automatic, Be Natural and thousands of Velvet B-sides are all bops. The same goes for Red Side songs, though. Just my preference. But fun theory, I honestly think that the side you like more is determined from your bias. Mine is Irene and I like Velvet's side more. While my sister likes Wendy and her favorite is the Red Side. 12. Twice improved a lot in every aspect of their career, and do not deserve such a criticism anymore, I swear to God. I was one of the biggest Twice haters for 2 years of their career. But only for myself though. I did not go out of my way to bully the girls or anything. Then Yes or Yes came, I started to like their music more, and their live vocals improved a lot over time. Their music kept getting better and more mature as time went by. I did hate cute concepts very much in the past, I don't now. I somehow ended up liking them a lot, and noticed how they improved in singing, dancing, and some members that were lacking a little bit improved in stage presence too, and the same goes for rapping too. They are already an average group with some members over average. There is no longer a need for any type of criticism if it's not with points of the possible improvements. 13. I don't mind if a group does not write their own music, all of you are going crazy over this. A group can have the same meaningful message as groups that write their own music. And please, realize that some groups do not even have a chance to write their own music, and then you are hating on them for it. Ever heard about Jenna's Notebook? If not, look it up, and you will understand. 14. I don't like high-pitched female rappers, I'm not hating on them. And I'm acknowledging the talent these girls have. The tone of the voice is just not my cup of tea. I like girl group rappers with a lower tone of voice, like Yeezy, for example. 15. Not having a stage presence can be excused in some cases, if you are at least trying. Some people need to have the experience first. Not everyone has a stage presence, since the very start. And think about how many times you feel sick. Imagine how many times overworked idols feel sick. Then you all come down to write comments on how lazy they are, or any other stupid thing. Some idols have anxiety, are uncomfortable with their clothes or feel sick. And yet, you will still see them put up their best performance, even if it's lacking, just because they want their fans to have a good performance. We all saw the best performance of our faves, and also the worst. and in some cases, their worst was still enjoyable, even though you could see that they were trying to do their best, even if it was very hard for them. Now, I'm not talking about the ones in which you can see that they don't care about the great performance anymore, but you should not cover them in hate either. Just encourage them politely to do better. They as well might be missing only a little love point. That's it for this video. Let me know if you agreed with some of my opinions, and don't be afraid to tell me if you disagree. I will try to go through all of your comments to talk with you. Subscribe, leave a like, and have a nice day.